Hey guys, one week no see. Let me tell you something. This perspective has a lot of fame on social media, and since it's so beautiful, people usually like to just relax somewhere and enjoy watching it. But when it comes to drawing it, people have some problem with it. We call it curvilinear perspective, or bent perspective, or let's just say 5-point perspective. In this video, you're gonna learn everything about it. Imagine that you have a wall in front of yourself, and you also have 3 points on the wall, one right in front of you, and the other two are on the right and left. Let's take a look at this situation in 3D. If you were the blue point, then you would be closer to the point that is in front of you. The others would be further. So if we want to draw this wall correctly, because the size of the wall are further, they should be smaller. Therefore, we should bend the wall and use curve instead of horizontal lines. As you can see in photography, some lenses can do this for you and they look very cool. One important thing is that the more you bend the wall, the more center of the wall becomes closer and the sides go further. We use this method to draw actual curved walls in 1 or 2 point perspective. After you bend it, we can add more lines to define the exact form of this wall. In this case, if a line is vertical in reality, it should be vertical in our drawing as well. Other lines follow the curves. And still you have to know that if something is further, then it's closer to the edge. And again, other lines follow the curves. To draw depth, lines go through the point at the center. Just in case you didn't know, every rule that we're talking about is symmetrical. And you should know that if something is in the middle of the horizontal line, like the top of this door, it should be horizontal. To draw a circle, I'm sorry to say you can't just cross, because the cross itself is a curve. It follows the form of the wall. Then again, using the curves, you'll find out the position of the 4 points of the circle. Now you can actually draw it. But what if we bend it the other way? This method helps us to show the walls that are actually curved. Again, a simple crossing is not gonna work. So make sure you follow the curves when you want to draw. And now you can finish the circle. How about combining these two methods? Right now we have 2 drawings on the right and left from the method 1, and 1 in the middle from the method 2. We use this to show the curves of the interior and exterior designs at the same time. Let's say we want a window on this wall. This time I'm gonna show you something. If you want to draw the depth accurate, you can use a copy of the whole curves and place it in the middle of the right wall. Now simply follow its lines to understand how you should draw the thickness of the wall. Let's remove it for now and follow our main curves to draw the rest. But in this method, vertical lines are still vertical. Let's go back to the first video that I showed you. What if we have some points on the top and bottom? It's just the same as the left and right, yes? So we can conclude that the whole wall should be a round shape, something like a circle. Just like before, let's add some lines to define the roundness of it. And by following the curves, you can draw the top face of your volume and decide how much depth it needs. And again, you can't cross. Follow the curved lines instead. And now our circle is ready. You can just put thousands of this method right next to each other and draw endlessly in curvilinear perspective. So why we call it 5-point perspective? Because of these 5 points.
And to end this, I want to draw your attention to this sentence. As long as you don't consider your limitations when you're thinking about new ideas, you won't be able to finish your projects. Sometimes you have to limit your ideas based on your abilities and save the bigger ideas for when your abilities are bigger. That's it for this video, and I hope to see you guys soon.